Hello everyone, and welcome to the Halloween Spooktacular. I'm your host, Count Aaron Fox. Tonight, we are going to be viewing not one, not two, but three special Halloween features that are sure to knock your socks off. First up, we have Shelley Meets Dr. Acula, a tale of a snail with a bad tooth and a mysterious doctor. Let's take a look.
This time of night. Hello?
Hey, Bobby. It's Shelley.
Shelley, do you realize that it's 4 o'clock in the morning?
I have a really bad toothache, and I can't sleep. Do you think you could come over?
Wow, sorry to hear that. Okay, I'll be right over.
Hi, Bobby. Oh, come on in.
Hey, Shelley. So you got a bad tooth, huh?
Oh, my tooth is killing me. And I don't know who to see about it.
Well, there's a new dentist in town. People say he makes house calls. Let's call him and see if he'll come over and look at your tooth.
Okay.
Hello, this is a message for Dr. Acula. Oh, I didn't think you would answer this time of night. I have a friend that has a bad tooth. Oh, you can come over now? Well, that's great! Okay, see you in a few minutes.
Well, that was quick.
Greetings. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Dr. Acula. So tell me, Bobby says you have a bad tooth.
Yeah, it's really painful. Can you look at it and see what's wrong?
That's strange. You can see Shelley's reflection in the mirror, but not Dr. Acula's.
Of course. But first, I must ask you a question. I am quite famished, and I never work on an empty stomach. I hope I'm not being too forward, but would you happen to have any corn dogs?
I sure do. Oh, coming right up. Here you go. One plump and juicy corn dog. I have ketchup to put on it if you want it.
Take that ketchup away. You don't put ketchup on a corn dog. What's the heck's the matter with you? Who does that? Honestly, please forgive me. I've seemed to have lost my manners. I don't mean to be rude. I just don't like ketchup.
Well, that's okay. I understand.
I will need to do more research on your tooth. It is getting late. I should be getting back to my laboratory to go over some material. I will contact you tomorrow. As for now, I bid you adieu.
Boy, that was strange.
Yeah, I've never seen anybody get that upset over ketchup.
I noticed something while you two were talking. I couldn't see his reflection in the mirror. Plus, I could swear I saw a bat
flying away
after he left. I have a sneaky suspicion that he may be
a vampire.
Let's look at my encyclopedia to see how to tell if a person is a vampire.
Okay.
Here it is. Clue number one. Vampires love corn dogs. Clue number two. Vampires are deathly afraid of ketchup. Clue number three. Vampires can't be seen in a reflection. And finally, vampires often travel as bats.
Dr. Acula's a vampire! We have to stop him from eating everyone's corn dogs. Let's find him while he's sleeping and pour ketchup on him. That ought to do the trick.
Great idea.
Look, there's a coffin. I wonder if he's sleeping in there.
I don't know. I'm afraid to look.
Me too. But we have to do it. Shh. Let's get the ketchup out and pour it on him.
Okay.
Great job,
Shelley.
Now everyone won't have to worry about losing their corn dogs.
Hey, what about my tooth?
We'll find you a new dentist. I promise.
As long as he doesn't like corn dogs.
Well, I'm sure that story sent a chill up your spine, didn't it? Oh, but I'm afraid the spooky antics are only beginning. We now move on to our next feature, called Schellenstein, the story of a mad scientist and his monster. We hope you enjoy.
Everything seems to be in order. It's finally time to bring my creation to life. All we need now is a strong bolt of lightning from the heavens.
One final connection, and I think we're ready. The process has begun. The process has completed. Look! It's moving. It's alive. It's alive! It's alive! It's alive! Let's reveal my creation.
I gotta get out of here.
But you are welcome. Come in.
You must be hungry. Would you like some bread?
Bread. Good. Bread. Good.
Would you like a drink?
Drink. Good. Drink. Good.
Would you like to hear some music?
Music! Good! Good!
You're my friend. Let's be best friends forever.
Friend! Good! Friend!
And so we end our scary story on a happy note, but we're about to go back to the thrills and chills because we have one final feature for you, the Wolf Dude, a tale of a man with a mysterious bite. Let's watch, shall we?
Shelly, can you come over? Oh, I'll explain when you get here.
Hey, Shelly.
Oh, glad you could make it. Come on in.
Hey, Bobby. What's up? Wow. What happened to your hand?
Well, I was taking a walk in the woods when suddenly this thing that looked like a dog came after me and it bit me.
Wow, that's really weird.
Yeah, and ever since that happened, I don't feel right.
I'm sure it'll be okay. You'll feel better when your hand heals.
Yeah, you're probably right. Oh, I don't feel good. What's going on with my hand? What's wrong with my face?
Last night.
I feel like somebody beat me up. Hey, where are my clothes? Why are they off? I better call Shelly.
What's up?
I woke up and I feel like somebody beat me up and I didn't have my clothes on. I have scratches on my body and my feet hurt.
And you were bitten by what you thought was a dog the other day, right? Was it a full moon?
Yes, it was a full moon last night.
It could only be one thing. You were bitten by a wolf dude.
A wolf dude? What am I gonna do?
There's only one cure. You have to be bitten by a snail when you turn into a wolf dude.
That sounds dangerous.
It is. But it's worth it.
Okay. See you tonight when the moon is full.
Okay. See you then.
feel better. I think it worked.
Yeah, I think it did work. You look like your old self.
Thanks, Shelley. You saved my life.
No problem. What are friends for, right?
Right. I'm gonna go home and clean up. I'll see you later.
See you later, Bobby.
Quite an unexpected ending, eh? Well, I'm afraid our night of terror ends here. The sun will rise soon, and it's about time I go back to sleep. Thank you all for joining me on my Halloween Spooktacular. I'm Count Aaron Fox, and I wish you all a happy Halloween. This video was made possible by the following patrons, especially Alex, my biggest fan.